Good morning, children. So today we'll continue chapter of friction. Actually, what is friction? See, the force that opposes or raises the motion of one surface across another is called friction, force of friction. Okay. Already we discuss some effects of force and other things. Then we try to study what are the types of forces. Sorry, types of friction. See, there is one force called static friction. One more force called sliding friction. One more type of friction called rolling friction. Then what is static friction? Static friction is the maximum value of frictional force between two surfaces. It is the maximum value of frictional force between two surfaces which can prevent one surface from sliding over the other. Means it will not, suppose these are two objects. One surface will prevent another surface from sliding. Means that keeps it static. It keeps the object stationary when it is placed on a surface. When it is placed on one surface, it keeps the object stationary. How? For example, it prevents a car from sliding down a hill when parked. Suppose there is a hill. When it is parked, that car will not move down because it is parked there. So static friction varies based on the force applied. So force applied also is one of the quantity which the friction, so static friction depends. It depends on force applied on the object, but it has a maximum value. But it has maximum value. See, when the applied force overcomes static friction, when you apply force, that force, when it comes, overcomes the static friction, the object starts moving. At this point, static friction ceases and kinetic friction or static friction takes over. So once, if the force applied is larger, then what happens? It gets a friction called kinetic friction or acceleration friction. Kinetic means movement, it starts movement. Kinetic or sliding friction. Okay. So for example, we'll discuss here. If the maximum static friction between a washing machine and a tile floor is 50 N. So this friction between washing machine and tile floor is 50 N. See, actually the force of friction is measured in a unit called Newton. That's why it indicates it is represented by N. And you try and move the machine with a force of 25 N. The force which it is having is what? Washing machine 50 N, and you try and move the machine with a force of 25 N. Then, so you are applying force of 25 N on the machine. The static friction will be 25 N, because when you are applying this much force, the static friction will be 25 N only. Means, if you increase the force you exert to 35 N, suppose your force increases to 35 Newton, what happens there? The static friction also will increase to 35 Newton. It will increase. this continues until the force you apply is greater than the maximum static frictional force, which is 50 N. This will continue till what time? Till your force of an object will be maximum or more than 50 N. At this point, the washing machine buzzes and starts sliding. So what happens here? So washing machine will buzz and start sliding. It starts movement. Once the machine starts sliding, there is no longer static friction, but only sliding friction. Once when you put all the clothes and when you apply the force more than the force which it has, so that to overcome the what friction force, the one force which you apply externally should be larger. So when your force applied is larger than 50 N only, then the machine starts movement. Means the there is no longer static friction, only sliding friction. So the cloth starts on sliding with the water and other materials there. Okay. So that is static friction. Then what is sliding friction? We'll try to find. So the name itself indicates slide. Slide is nothing, just movement. Okay. Or kinetic. So sliding friction, or it is also called kinetic friction. Sliding friction or kinetic friction is the force that results from two surfaces being pressed against each other while sliding. So here, two surfaces, this is one surface, this is one surface, X and Y. If two surfaces are being pushed with each other, then that produces sliding friction. It is the sliding friction that makes sure an object does not continue to move forever. Why? When the sliding friction is acting on one object, that force only is responsible. When that force is acting on that particular object, it does not move. That is called sliding friction. However, sliding friction is lesser than static friction for some metal in contact. So sliding friction is lesser than static friction in some materials, not all, in few materials. That is why it is easier to slide a piece of furniture over the floor after you start moving. The furniture which is on the floor is easily movable when you start moving it. Then it is to get moving in first place. Slowly it starts moving. Example I will give. For sliding friction, washing machine pushed along the floor. Washing machine is pushed along the floor, or a book being slid on the table. A book is made to slid on the table. Because of the high magnitude of sliding friction, one refers to roll an object on wheel rather than the dragging. See, the best example is, I will give suitcase. One suitcase which is not having wheels like this. One suitcase which is having, there are wheels to one suitcase, there are no wheels to the one suitcase. So which is easier to move here? The one which has wheels is nothing, sliding friction. This will move very faster compared to the one which is not having the what? Wheels. Means one prefers to roll an object when on wheel rather than dragging. Instead of dragging like this, if you drag here, this may get spoiled and you may feel little weight. But when there is wheel, so that wheel provides what friction? Sliding friction. That moves, that makes the movement of suitcase easier. This is the case. So this is because the rolling friction is lesser than sliding friction. So rolling friction is lesser than sliding friction. Then what is actually a rolling friction? this way. Okay. Now what is the rolling friction? We'll try to find. See, rolling friction occurs when an object rolls across the other. When an object rolls across the other, this is rolling friction. When it moves. Okay, for example, when a ball or a tire or a wheel rolls on surface, when ball rolls, wheel rolls, tire rolls on a surface, what happens there? That is their example. Rolling friction is a resistive force that slows down the motion of a rolling ball. Suppose a ball is made to move like this. It will stop for a while, it will travel and the ball will stop here. So this ball is nothing, it is having the friction opposing. It will resist the motion of the rolling ball. It is not easy to slide a suitcase on the floor. That's why I told this example is for rolling friction. To slide a suitcase is not easier, but to slide a suitcase which has wheels is easier, because the rolling friction will be easier and it makes the object to move very easily. So these are the types of friction: static friction, solid friction and rolling friction.